One of the latest events in the Dragon Ball Super manga was Mirus and Whis spectating Goku's fight against Moro. It's quite a small thing, but as far as Dragon Ball goes, these are the type of things that happen that foreshadow to bigger events. To put some context around what I'm saying, in one of the latest chapters of Dragon Ball Super, Whis and Mirus are watching Goku fight Moro. Goku's using Ultra Instinct and Moro is still winning. When Whis is watching, although having known Goku for a longer period of time, he does not care that Goku is losing. He is 1000% impartial to whatever happens. However, Mirus, on the other hand, who is a much younger angel, is completely freaking out that Goku's losing and is clearly on his side. Now, normally that would be expected. All the gods previously have been watching Goku fight, they've always supported Goku, but the difference this time is that the angels are straight up not allowed to do that. If they pick a side, they are now at risk of actually dying. That's the one thing that can defeat the angels. So, while Mirus is freaking out watching Goku lose, Whis tells him that you can't be doing that. As an angel, your job is to not fight everyone's battles, but to simply stay impartial. That's why you've been given so much power. Mirus was the reason that Goku is able to master Ultra Instinct so quickly. He is clearly a very skilled angel, but the difference between him and every other angel in existence is he was actually introduced into the series by being a part of the Galactic Patrol, someone who goes around Universe 7 and basically saves it from injustice. Knowing where he came from, to do that, it goes against everything that makes up who the angels are and why they even exist. He wanted to protect Universe 7, and then when he met Goku, he realized that this guy could actually learn Ultra Instinct, let me teach it to him really quick, and then he got caught and was in big trouble by the Grand Priest. This type of feeling to serve justice and do good in the universe isn't something that most angels have to deal with. It is a very human reaction that Mirus is having, and when you're an angel, that is the only thing that could put your life at risk, thinking like a mortal. As Mirus watches Goku getting beaten down, he screams out without even realizing, "If we don't do something, the Earth and so many more planets will be in danger." That's when Whis has to firmly put him back in line and tell him, pretty much, your place as an angel is not to interfere in these mortal affairs. Even if Moro does absorb the Earth, it's not necessarily a bad thing. If we interfere, we will only be messing with the course of space and time. Mirus tries to say something back to him, he's like, "I understand that, but..." The look on Mirus's face, he is not happy with what Whis just said. This entire arc started out in a way that made you think Vegeta was going to be the one to take down Moro. He was the one who was taking his time training on Yadra to learn the precise technique to finish off Moro. And that still could happen, but there's a small sub-story going on here about Mirus not wanting to follow the angel rules. For the longest time, people have wanted to see the angels in Dragon Ball Super fight. It's been 7 years since Whis got introduced, and this entire time, the angels have stuck strongly to their code of never fighting. But if I were to bet on any angel to break that law, it would be Mirus. The way that he already went against the angels by signing up for Universe 7's Galactic Patrol, he's one of those characters that seems to not be able to sit by and watch. If Vegeta somehow doesn't beat Moro, Mirus having some kind of interference and presence would be my next guess. It's funny too, because all this time in Dragon Ball Super, no one knew that Mirus was an angel. He was just working on the Galactic Patrol. Most people thought that he was just a side character, but absolutely not. He is an actual angel, so if he did fight Moro, there's nothing that Moro would be able to do. This whole time, Mirus was just the strongest guy without anyone even knowing. Let me know what you think about this, because hands down, if you're just skimming through the chapters and not really paying too much attention, you could easily miss this, but they keep coming back to Mirus, and I don't think it's the last time they'll do it too. And the potential of an angel actually fighting is actually looking pretty strong right now. Let me know what you think. I want to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next Dragon Ball video.